Can take the tablet from him so that I want to be practitioner. Thank you. Are you guys okay? Fine?
Yeah.
Happy?
Yeah.
The kids, children, are you all okay? Thank you. Good? That's good. Alright, today we're going to speak a little bit of the subject. Before we go any further, do you remember anything about last Sunday? Yeah? Remember anything about last Sunday? Roof, yeah? What about roof? Yeah? Roof decision, yeah? What else? Yes. Good profile, good heart, yeah? That's very good. Anything else? Remember the roof? Who was roof? I mean, who was roof? You know? Huh? Moabai, okay? Who did she follow? Naomi, why? You know, Naomi? Yeah?
Because if she never looked after Naomi, she wants to look after Naomi, she made that Naomi was old, and she lived herself. Naomi was okay.
Okay, that's. She wanted to look after Naomi because Naomi was old and take care of her. There was Ruth and somebody else. There were two of them. Who was the other one? Huh? Orpha, yes. What happened to the other Orpha? Did she go with Naomi? No? Okay. That's a very good subject, I think. The brother will continue with that next time. We want to learn about Ruth. Amen. Even myself was so blessed. I was so happy with that. It was a very good subject. But today we're going to speak something a bit different than that. Last time I spoke to you, We spoke about something with me. Do you remember?
The guide.
The guide, yes. Good. We spoke about the guide, which was very important. Do you remember anything about the guide? Yeah. What did we say?
I
want
to help you to lead the way.
The guide will help you to lead the way. So that we all need the guide, isn't it? Without a guide, you'll be lost. Isn't it? Good. That's a very good one. So today I'm going to speak about personal experience, your own personal experience. We all have our own experience, but today we're going to speak about personal experience. Before that, let's read our Bible in the same book that we read last time, when we spoke about the guide. We're going to take a book of Acts. Acts chapter 2, verse 57. Thank you. Repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. So today I'm going to speak about your personal experience. You know what I mean by personal experience? Who knows what I mean by that? What, do you understand? Why do you know what personal experience? Experience. Who knows what experience is? Experience. Yeah, something you find out, that's good. Nowadays, when you go to look for a job, they will ask you, do you have any experience? So, for example, you want to go work in Tesco, for example, as a cashier with those in the things, red card things, they will ask you, do you have experience? Have you ever done it? Everywhere you go, most of the jobs, they ask people that, do you have experience? Have you ever done that? With that experience, some jobs they won't take you. They will say no. That's why when you are thinking you're 11, you go, you're 10 or you're 11. Yeah, off your 10, then they send you to do some work experience, isn't it? Yeah. It depends where you want to. If you want to go and work in a bank, you're 10, 11, they will send you. They find a bank somewhere way for you to go and learn something, isn't it? They'll teach you how to, so that in future, at least you've got an experience. When you go to apply for a job, they ask you, have you ever worked in a bank before? You say, yeah, when I was in year 10, year 11, I did this, I did that. They say, that the bank will trust you. And wherever you go to work, they will trust you, they will take you from there. But with that experience, they cannot take you. There's few jobs that can take you without experience. But most of the jobs, it depends what you want to do. You will need to have an experience before they take you. Do you know why? Because you know why they need you to have experience? Do you know why? So that you know what you do. So that you won't destroy anything, the machines. That you won't give people more change. When someone give you buy a bread for 20p and give you 50p, you know your experience, you know, okay, I have to give it 10, 30p. You won't give back £1, isn't it? If you give back £1, that's a big mistake. And every time you're giving £1, they're losing. That's why they want people who have experience. That when they give you 50p and the bread costs 20p, you give back 30p. And that way, even the boss will trust you. When you tell them you have experience, they will trust you. They will give you the job that they have. They will tell, okay, he can do it. Some jobs, they won't even come next to you, behind you, and looking after you, following you how you're doing your job. They will even say, this girl, he knows how to do this girl, he knows how, she knows how to do her job. They will leave it to you. We're going to read something about Abana. He says, in the mentioned faith, he says, and usually, people who have faith are people who have experience. People who have faith are people who have experience. And he continues, experience brings faith. So when you have an experience, you have faith. You know, you can do it. I have an experience of playing the guitar. I have faith. If you give me the guitar, I can play the guitar closing my eyes. I have faith in myself. I can do it. I have that experience, I've already played. So for you to have faith, you have to have an experience. Today, I can't make cook for food or whatever and say, give it to Ezra, we eat it. I can't trust Ezra. I haven't got faith in Ezra to eat food by himself. But you guys, your mommy and daddy trust you, isn't it? They will put chips there, they won't come and feed you chips. Did your mom feed you? Did your mom feed you? No. No, you feed yourself, isn't it? You go your hand. Because why? They have faith in you. They have
They've seen you done it, you have an experience of eating yourself. So it gives them more faith. You see, to do it. And even yourself, because you know how to eat, you know how where to put your food in your mouth. No one will tell you because you've got that experience. You know it already, isn't it? So that's how you create your God word. But Bible says, to have that faith, you have to have an experience. Even in Christians, there's a lot of people when they become Christian, they haven't got enough faith. It's because they haven't gone through an experience. And that's why I'm speaking about personal experience, your own personal. You have to go to your own experience for you to have faith in what we're preaching, for you to have faith in this message, for you to have faith in God.
So an experience is very, very important. Because without the experience, I can't trust you, even myself. You see, I can't trust somebody who comes to stand in a pulpit and preach without an experience, isn't it? You won't be able to trust a person, you'll think that's one is a joker. You can't trust, you can't call this person my brother in a message or my sister if he hasn't got that experience. Because once you have that experience, you have now faith in that person. You have faith in that person, you believe the person, whatever you do, is a Christian. But Abraham continues and said, it behoves us to have an experience before faith can ever accomplish very much. In other words, it's very important. It's a must for us to have an experience before faith can do anything, before you can have anything, before you believe. There's other person with my mind saying before you call Jesus, saying that Jesus is Christ. You have to have an experience. You tell me, how do you know that Jesus is Christ? Is it because that daddy told you? Is it because mommy told that Jesus is our Savior? Or is it your own experience? Because there come a time where mommy and daddy will not be there. Mommy and daddy will now look after you and say that, follow the message, do this. I give you my example. When I left my dad's house, I was still young. Yeah, I was a bit young. Some people were telling my dad, you left your son by living by himself. And maybe he won't be able to do this. He won't be able to do this. It was good for them, you see. They were worried about me, saying that maybe I won't be able to do this. I won't be able to feed myself. I won't be able to survive in this world by myself because I was a bit younger. But my dad told him, he had faith in me. Because he's seen what I've done, that I'm capable of being by myself. So in the future, you two will take that decision, probably in 3 years' time, to be by yourself, where mommy and daddy will not be there. And you have to make sure that you have an experience. Daddy and mommy will not follow you every time in the morning, in the house, knocking, go to church. You need to pray and do this. They are doing it now. They are training you now at home how to pray, how to do this, how to read your message, how to put your faith in God. So that when they are not there, you will not need them. You will have faith in what you, because you have experience of something that you've done. You have or you know what you believe. No one will move you. No one will tell you that this message is wrong. Don't follow what you run. Don't do this. Don't listen to these people. Because you made an experience for yourself. I've seen a lot of people, a lot of young people that I spoke to. They had some youth meeting. I've seen a lot of them. Some of my friends, we all came in a message together, got baptized together. But some of them are not even on the message. Some of them left the message.
message. Some of them don't pray anymore. Why? Because they missed something. They missed the experience. They were just coming to church because mommy was coming. Because daddy was coming. It was in their own personal experience. So once you make your own decision, your own person, whether mommy or daddy don't come to church, whether mommy or daddy don't pray anymore, you will do what the word of God says. You will pray, you will go to church. Don't forget that. That's you have to make your own experience. Decide. Yeah.
Are you with me? So it's very, very important, to have your own personal experience with God before you can even have faith. That's why in some word, they cannot trust you without experience. Once you got experience, they will trust you. That's why they have faith in you at that workplace. You want to go and work in a hospital? And as long as you have experience, they will let you, okay, fine. You can treat this person. You can do this. Without experience, you cannot trust in somebody's life. Imagine I had Brother Panam talking about someone going for an operation. He said, you know, when you go for that operation, or probably maybe it was a heart operation or something. He said, and he came to a doctor, it was a new doctor. If I'm not mistaken, it was a new doctor. And Brother Panam said, I prefer having an operation with somebody who has the experience of having an operation than a new person. New person just finished many medicals, a new doctor, maybe finished 2 days ago. And today we say, okay, take this ball here, do an operation, it's hard. Even yourself, you'll be afraid when you tell him he just finished 2 days ago, you'll be, you know what I mean? I remember when I used to cut hair before that, even some people used to be like, they didn't want me to cut their hair because I said, when did you cut your hair? I want to cut 2 people. Ah, only 2 people. And then you want to play with my hair. See, people will not even let you touch their hair because you only did cut 2 people and you didn't do it good. They want somebody who has an experience to do that. Even myself, when I go to the barber shop, I sit there, I look at that barber shop, because you won't mess around with my hair. I want somebody who has an experience of cutting hair. See, now I put my faith in that person, I can give him my hair for him to do it. So the same thing with us, with you. Same thing with us. We want an experience. There are things that come with life that we go through experience. There are things that happen in our lives that will lead us and make us have an experience. Let's look at Israel. I give you the story of Israel. In Israel, at one of the time, they had a king named Saul. It was, Barbara said he was the tallest person in Israel. A very strong person. And he was trained to fight. He was a strong one among other people. He was trained to fight that man. And suddenly there was this man called Goliath. So Barbara said he was the tallest. Had shoulders, maybe bigger than me. Muscles, everyone in Israel were afraid of him. But when Goliath came, who was stronger than him in Saul, Saul was afraid to face Goliath. Let's read Brother Barnum in the same message. He said, now notice, many times in the scripture, we take a firmness over the sin of Israel. When they were in trouble, Israel, when they were in trouble, and there was a war broke out between Israel and the Philistines, and Israel had gathered themselves over the side of the hill. Okay? And the battle was set in order, but no one was able to go to the battle because over on the other side, the enemy had a great challenge. Israel, they wanted to go and fight. They was on the other side. Are you with me? They was on the other side. And there was nobody who was able to stand and fight. Even though Saul was there, who was a strong man, to go and fight. They were afraid. No one has an experience of fighting. But what I'm saying, and as it was then, so it is now, that when God people start to go to, start to do something, the enemy always have a challenge. Challenge you for it. When you're a Christian, there will come a point in your life that you will have challenges in your life. Just the way the children of Israel, they had that Goliath, you too will have your Goliath for you to challenge. So that's why I don't want you to be like Saul, who was strong physically. You look at him. He was training how to fight with weapons and everything. But he couldn't face that challenge. That's the challenge that I challenged Goliath. Challenge the enemy, you have to have faith to challenge that person. You have to believe in yourself that I will get that. You know, to have a good grade in school, that's a big challenge, isn't it? To have a good grade in your school, in your study. Because you know it's not easy, especially when it comes to trying to do your Jesus. Is there anyone with Jesus in your nation? Oh, goodness, that's a big, big challenge to do Jesus. Now, so if you have no faith in yourself, that's why you got your 1, your 2, your 3, for you go to your experiences, your 5, your 6, your 7, you all go 8, 9, that's the experience you're going. So for you to face the Jesus you want, the last one, that's the big challenge. So without those experiences, without you studying, doing your effort to study, you won't be able to make it. You won't be able to face that challenge or that person who's your Jesus for you to have a good one. So an experience is very important. And but when I'm saying this, listen to this. I say, but while in the army of Israel, Saul, the great warrior, if there was any man in the whole army that was more apt to be able to go and fight with that, this giant was Saul. In Israel, the person who was able to fight Goliath, it was Saul. It wasn't even David, it was Saul. First, he was a well-trained warrior. You know a warrior? He was well-trained. So, they trained him very well. He knew how to fight with guns, he knew how to fight with this. He was well-trained. Listen, he knew all the maneuvers, how to dodge the spear and how to knock them off with his shield. And above that, he was head and shoulder above any man in his army. He was more physical for a match, and he was a trainer of men. He was even training people how to fight. He was so strong. He was in the whole army. He was the tallest, the army of Israel. He was strong, he was training people. But listen to this. But as it was with Saul, in those days, we found the same thing existing today. Listen, as it was with Saul, who was strong physically, who could go and fight with that Goliath, as it was with Saul, you feel me, baby? As it was with Saul on that day, so it's the same with us today. Listen, the same thing exists today among people who go to church.
some of them who are the best trained scholars has left as least faith in God. Some of people who are well trained, school, oh, I'm a doctor of this. Oh God, this is so intelligent. My school is always number one, I always have high grade. But those people are mostly people are people who have less faith in God. And my name go further, I said, but I'm going down quickly, listen. But if we notice, while this giant was making this great boast and this great theology, it would be standing there, well trained to know how to fight, but he never had an experience with God. That person saw, who was well trained how to fight, but he never had an experience. It's like somebody, you meet somebody on the street, he say, I'm that natural, I'm a karate. I can beat you anytime. And we can wah, 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 wah. So somebody doing that, I'm so strong, wah, wah, wah. And the other person just look on the floor, pick a stone, and wow, he just hit him straight away. That person, he had an experience, they were the trained them how to fight, but he never fought on the street. It's like so. He had an experience where he was, but he never fought before. To you, Christian, that's why it's very important to have. So Saul had no experience. Saul was well trained to finish. Saul was well trained, no experience to fight. But someone, but when I say someone, God had a small man named David. David had an experience, but when he says, David had an experience because before fighting Goliath with his sling shot, he killed the lion. One day he was back in the yard where he was feeding the sheep, and the lion came. He killed the lion with that sling on. So David had an experience where he already killed a lion. Imagine a lion. See the experience that David had. So when David, with that experience he had, he was able to face Goliath. Otherwise, David wouldn't be able to face Goliath. Like Saul. Saul was trained, but he never had an experience to fight somebody. He came before Goliath. He fell. The same with you, you and me. Without an experience with God, without your personal experience with God, you won't be able. You will not be able to resist the devil, resist all those bad influences out there in schools, where you're going with your friends. Without experience, you won't be able to resist them. You need to have your own experience with God to be like David, to face anything that comes. As I said, many people that came in the message, some of them are not. Some of them have dropped. Some of them are calling this message whatever. Some of them are just saying this is a rubbish thing. This is a people. You wait, you see people swearing or balancing whatever. Why? They had no experience. They just came. Just because mommy was coming. Just because that person was there for me to see. Don't come because mommy is forcing me to come. Don't come because dad is forcing you to come. Come because it's your own personal experience. It's because you want God. Because you love God. So that even when mommy doesn't come, even if mommy, daddy doesn't come, you love God, you want to come. This message is not for mommy. It's not for daddy. This message is also for you. That's why you have messages to go and read. When you see something is wrong with the message, I said, mommy, this is what the prophet said. Daddy, this is what the prophet said. Why aren't we doing this? Why don't we do this? Because you have this. Once you go there, you have an experience with God, no one will ever move you. Nothing will ever shake you. So it's very important to have your own experience.
Okay? We're going to finish there. Going to continue next time. This time is going. Trying to read something. Any question you got? Anybody got any question? No? Yeah? Any questions? No questions? Good. So, it's very important to have your own personal experience. Without your own personal experience, you won't be able to do anything. Barbana even said, you won't be able to understand your Bible, the message that we're preaching. Because a lot of people just read the message, they read, they don't even understand it. They don't even understand. You already, yes, the version we consider. Yes, it is written there, the version we consider. But they are still, you know, we see people waiting for the version to consider. There are still people waiting for that. But we know it's already happened. Long time ago. You see? There are people reading. Why? Because they have no experience with God. They have no experiences. So it's very important for you to understand the message. For you to say amen to everything the message says. Experience with God is very, very important. Amen. We're going to sing a song and we're going to finish and pray. What did you say? Let's talk about Jesus, the King of Kings. Let's talk about Jesus.